the OGs in the barbershop, they kind of like raised me for real. Like they gave me a lot of game in the street, a lot of things I need to know about. You know, I used to work in there.
I'm trying to do that.
Oh, I ain't gonna say nothing. I just hope she got an auntie. What's up?
We got hella memories over there. It's just the way to be. The owner of the barbershop, Rick, used to take me in the beauty salon. They used to pass out the hat, and they used to drop dollars in the hat and stuff. So I started doing it like that. Like, I just like, shit, if I need some money, I could just go to this beauty salon. I know said they're gonna give me some money. You feel me? I used to walk through there and be like, oh my God, I'm blessed. I used to have like $200 walking through there. I used to be moonwalking through that motherfucker. One of my homeboys, Lodi, used to show me how to dance and tick and shit. I did that shit all the way up till I got it, you feel me? I first fell in love with music when I was, probably fell in love with it when I was like 9, because that's when I learned how to sing. I always liked it, but I started loving it when I realized that I could do it.
All right, let's go.
Yes, sir, let's go. When I was doing it back then, when I was young, I was just doing it with no intention of nothing. You feel me? Like, I was just singing, you feel me? Like, that was just what I did, just sing.
Damn, come on, little queen. Ah,
fuck! Yeah, you should gotta fly in, like, man.
FYB, you know, it stands for Fresh Young Boys. I met all these niggas in elementary, but we formed FYB in high school in 11th grade. You know, everybody got real talent, something real special.
I think FYB is like Dungeon Family or something like that. I get vibes from all different artists because we looked up to all the Atlanta natives, you know what I'm saying?
See, everybody at FYB got different stories and they got different messages to tell, even though we all came up together. And that's what makes it so powerful to me.
Everybody can't sing. So that one person, he could really sing, like this shows like naturally.
This nigga walking the neighborhood sing. 12 at night, like nigga, street lights been on, like nigga, I'm in the crib and shit, you feel me? This nigga out here by himself singing loud as hell, you did.
That's one nigga that ain't shy. You feel what I'm saying? He never been shy. Anytime somebody ask him, oh, let me hear you sing, he'll never shy away from it. So he used to sing all through the neighborhood and, you know, just kept building and kept building, kept growing. Sung his way all the way to the top.
Oh, I don't fuck with all in the street.
Let me get a box. Let me get a box. I'm on your ass.
He used to sing on the TV every morning before class, and he used to do the school news and all that. So I was like, oh yeah, he gonna be a star. I always knew he was gonna be a star.
Bro, I am tripped out, bro. They switched the screen, bro. I'm thinking I'm on the bottom, bro. I promise. No, that's cap. Damn.
I won the first two. Yes, I did. I came in second place.
I think the turning point for me was when I turned 12 years old. It was this dude at the barbershop. His name was Zoe. Zoe got me in the studio. We made a song. It was like, I see you over there, girl, looking so sexy. What's your name? What's your friend? I know you ain't, girl. Some shit like that. But I was singing in front of the Kroger Plaza, and this dude named Exquisite saw me singing. I used to just go out there and sing all the time. I remember he came in the barbershop. He was like, bro, I got a song. And he started singing it to me or whatever. And I was like, I gotta get on it. I remember I came home and I was writing shit. I was on the phone with him. I was writing my verse to it. And Dex put us in the studio and then we recorded Girl of My Life. We added that to the demo tape. And after that, the rest was like history. You know what I'm saying? The song blew up around Decatur. You know, that was like the big turning point for me. And after that, we just started pursuing it. And it's just, shit, here we are now. You feel me?
I'm finna show y'all the infamous cut, man. You did some bad shit, anything, man. You take this cut right here, you gonna get through that bitch. Our parents weren't gonna let us just kick it in front of their crib 24/7, so barbershop really where you can be yourself.
It was like the heartbeat of the neighborhood. It shaped us in a different way, you know what I'm saying? Cause we took them different traits or all them different like lessons and we brought it back to the hood, or we just, it stuck with us and it's like, it shaped us today. That was like real role models at the time, you can say. They always been there with us. There's a lot of people that may not believe or see your vision like you see it, but you gotta just like paint your own picture. You gotta be your own Mozart.
When we used to be at the barbershop,
every day. We know we're gonna talk about what we like, talk about money, you know, felt reminiscent of what you're doing, gambling, being there doing whatever we wanna do.
The barbers were always, you know what I'm saying, they was real connected with the kids that would come through there. Like, we all got our line up through there. Jacquees used to work in there, sweeping up hair.
This barbershop, basically home. Like, this is our safe haven. Like, this is where we come to kick it. We tell all our people to meet up, even before shows now, today. Like, we'll tell them meet up at the barbershop, and we'll pull off and go to the club. Yeah.
Kind of stuck.
Julio
was good, though.
Kind of stuck. Guess what I'm sitting here with. Hold on.
That's your sound.
Yeah.
What up, Lil? Nigga ain't little no more.
Boy, you sound like a grown man. Yeah, what are you doing?
Coming in the barbershop, I think he was trying to get a job there. He wanted to sweep, like, when he first started really, really coming around. But we already had somebody there. And once he was gone, because he had got to be too old, you know, once you get about 17, you can't sweep for us no more. So once you could talk back, he got to get you up out of there. So we needed somebody new, and that's when we brought in Jacquees. And he was good. He was one of the best ones that we ever had. Because he was willing to do whatever you asked him to do. He liked money. Heavy. He liked money. So whatever he had to do to get him an extra dollar, that's what he was going to do. They always asked him to sing. That's why he was always singing. Somebody was always asking him to sing. Because they had heard about it. I remember I had a girlfriend at the time. She used to call him Hollywood before he was even big. Because how he dressed and how he carried himself, and him already being a star without being a star. So even now, to this day, when she sees him, she still calls him Hollywood.
This is the first time I ever thought about it, but Danny the only barber I ever had. Danny been cutting my hair for 10 years now. And he been cutting Queen heads for probably longer than that.
Well, you know, a lot of places, they shun the kids. They don't have nowhere to hang out at, so it was just like an extension of the neighborhood, so everybody, all the kids would just come over and get able to hang out because they were the younger guys, so they don't want them out there doing nothing crazy. So
Danny like our big brother.
I'm like, everybody's big brother, and when you come and talk to me about anything, and I used to all, you know, when the older guys would leave, you would come stay with me because everybody's gone. So they could hang out in the shop till I left, and I used to leave till about 11, 12 o'clock at night. So that's why it was always cool for them to come up there, because I would allow them to stay.
Honestly, I feel like the biggest R&B singer.
Hey, you want to get in the car,
saying?
You got to come on right
now. I feel like I'm the hottest, you know what I'm saying? I know I ain't been in the game that long, like, on this level, but right now, in this moment, I feel like the biggest.
What's good? Just the way that we was brought up. I appreciate the love.
Thank you for all the love.
Uh-huh. Go. You know, it's a good space to be in. I ain't gonna never stop.
It's just the way that we was brought up, right?
You gotta go hustle.
Hey.
Go get it.
Million ways to stack a dollar.
What? Gotta do something. Yeah. Alright.
Teachers teach, but OG's taught us.
OG.
We up next.
Yeah.
I'm FYB, I got playing mindset.
Yeah.
Pick up if I call ya. Hang with a baller.